Hey YouTube, Structil here, bringing you guys the new, recently released Structure Deck Rocket Revolt, and also giving you guys a $30 budget deck profile for the deck Rockets. So basically this Structure Deck comes in with the new support for the Rocket decks, which is pretty nice to see some love for Rockets, and also introduces us some new two new boss monsters, a new topologic monster, and a new Borload monster, which is the new Borload fusion monster, which we'll be going over for a sec. And then we are, and then also this structure deck also comes in with some reprints, which is easier for people who wants to build Rockets, and also some other fantastic reprints that we'll be going over in just a few minutes. So without further ado, let's get on with this new structure deck, which I'm honestly really excited for this particular structure deck, because I know a lot of people are interested in the new Rocket Link, which this structure deck comes in with some neat stuff. So in the structure deck you get the beginner's guide, which, to be honest, for a deck like Rockets, I don't really think that this deck is actually really good for beginners, but if you actually get the gist, then yeah, this is actually pretty good. So pretty much the beginner's guide, it tells you everything about how to play Yu-Gi-Oh!, like basically about the cards, the phases, the turns, all the summoning stuff. And then you are also, you are getting a playmat, which I'll be showing you in just a sec, if I can get this to open. There we go. So this is what the playmat looks like, which honestly is really cool, but considering this is a paper playmat, it's not really my favorite, since basically all the folding just kind of ruins it a little. But anyways, it's still really cool. You got the Borload monster, and then you got the topologic monster right there. If I can fold, which I can't. And then you got the actual deck itself right here. You can see the new topologic monster. Let's just get it open it with. I really hate this. Oh, I got scissors right here. Okay, there we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Also, you got this Duel Links advertisement right here, which I never got to play Duel Links. I did try to download it before, but I ended up deleting it because it was actually taking up too much of my space. So, yeah. And then, so we got the new Topologic Monster, Topologic Zerboros, I believe it's called. So basically, this new topologic monster, I believe locks out your opponent's, monster zones and even extra monster zones, which is pretty cool. And also, kind of have a bit of effect like, Bomber Dragon, which, if a monster is actually special summoned to where a link monster points to, banish the cards, which, instead of sending it to the graveyard like Bomber does, yeah, it's banished instead. And then, sorry for the lighting. We got the new Borload Fusion Dragon, Borload Furious Dragon, which first we got the new. Not the, like not new. First we got the Link Monster, then we got the Synchro, then Xyz, which actually came out last month in Rising Rampage, and now we got the Fusion Monster, which I believe is going to be debuting in the anime next week, since we are getting the Revolver and Soulburner duel next week. And then we got Quadboral Dragon, which is really nice to see some more support for Rockets. Then we got, now we're actually on to the main deck with the new card, Silver Rocket Dragon, which I believe this is the one that searches out of your opponent's extra monster zone. Well, not extra monster zone. Your opponent's extra deck, that's what I meant to say. And also, you can actually banish one of their cards, which is actually pretty insane. And then we got Rocket Tracer, which, again, new support for the Rockets. You can target one face-up monster you control, destroy it, and if you do, special summon one Rocket Monster from your monster from your extra deck for the rest of the turn, except Dark Monsters. You can only use each effect. You can only use this effect of Rocket Tracer once per turn, which, honestly, your rocket deck is basically Dark Monsters, so it doesn't really matter. Also, this is the new tuner, so this would actually work great with the Boralos Synchro Monster, Boralos Savage Dragon, which unfortunately it's not been reprinted in the structure deck. And then we got Absorute Dragon, which is another new Rocket Monster. If you control a Rocket Monster, you can special summon this card from your hand. You can only special summon Absorute Dragon once per turn this way. If this card is sent to the graveyard, you can add one Rocket Monster from your deck to your hand. You can only use this effect of Absorute Dragon once per turn. So, basically, another really great card. And then we got Zero Day Blaster. Tribute one Dark Link Monster, then target cards in the field equal to its Link ratings, destroy them, which is pretty cool. And then we got Rocket Recharger, Explorer Rocket Dragon, Checksum Dragon, and then we're getting into some other reprints. Answer Rocket Dragon, Auto Rocket Dragon, Magna Rocket Dragon, Shell Rocket Dragon, Metal Rocket Dragon, Rocket Synchron, which is actually a really good reprint, especially for the Dragon Links that's coming out. Gateway Dragon, Defrag Dragon, Background Dragon, Levro Dragon, and then we get some other random reprints. Paladin of Aetherlin, Dragon Knight of Creation, Keeper of the Shrine, World Chalice Guard Dragon, which is actually pretty cool reprint as well. Raiden Hand of the Lightsworn, Boar Supplier, which is a new spell, new spell card. During each standby phase, if you control a Boral Link Monster, you can target one Rocket Monster in your graveyard, special summon it, but destroy it during the end phase. You can only use this effect of Boral Supplier once per turn. And then, here's a new fusion card for your Fusion Boral Monster, Rapid Trigger. So, fusion summon one fusion monster from your extra deck by destroying fusion monster listed on it from your field, but it can only attack monster special summoned from the extra deck. Also, it is unaffected by activated cards. Also, it is unaffected by activated effects from any other monster special summoned from the extra deck. You can only activate one Trapper Trigger per turn, which is pretty cool. Instead of like tributing it, destroys them, which for Rockets, they basically destroy themselves and then their effects are triggered, so that's really cool. Squib Draw, and then Quick Launch, which these two are actually pretty cool reprints. I think they were secrets, but seeing them as a common is pretty cool now. Although they're actually cheap, but I think they're actually going to be a little bit more pricey now because, again, Guard Dragons. And then we got Boot Sector Launch, Boral Regenerator, Dragon Shrine, Ruins of the Divine Dragon Lords, Return of the Dragon Lords, Bombardization, Twin Twister, cool reprint, Execute Protocols, Red Reboot, which is, again, another really great reprint. But if you actually don't like the common, you can actually wait another couple of weeks with the Mega 10, since it is coming out as a secret rare. Link Turret, Mirror Force Launcher, Mirror Force, of course, Magic Cylinder, Imperial Order, and then we got Borlo Dragon, which, as much as I'm actually really happy to see that this card is reprinted in the structure deck so that, like, everyone can gain access to this card, it kind of pains me to see this is a common, because I'm actually more used to seeing it as a secret rare, but still, I'm actually really happy for the budget players that can play this card now, since it is easily one of the best Link monsters in the game, and is also very generic, so now you got yourself a new Borlo Dragon. Triple Burst, which is actually another reprint that needs to happen, since I've been hearing that this card has been going up $15 to $20, which is actually really nice for our Triple Burst Dragon to get a reprint. And then we got Booster Dragon. But that is it for what's in the structure deck, and I'll be going over the $30 budget very shortly, so I'll see you guys then. Alright, so it took me a little while, but I finally managed to get myself ready for the $30 budget deck profile for Rockets, and of course these are only just the cards that are in the structure deck. I do plan on making a different Rocket deck profile really soon that comes with other cards, and I wouldn't really say that this is the type of deck that would win any like big tournaments like any YCSs, but if you're actually looking for a deck that's only just for fun, or you just actually want a friend to try out, then this is pretty much the deck that you actually want to play. So without further ado, let's get started on this deck profile. So kicking off, I'm running 3 Silver Rocket Dragon, and I've already talked about what this card does. For a recap, basically this card looks at your opponent's extra deck, and they can actually choose one monster and banish it. So this is actually a really great card to like slow down or even stop any combo decks. And then I'm running 3 Rocket Tracers, which is another new card that came in the set. I mean, this structure deck, I meant. Basically, this card destroys a rocket, then special summons another rocket, which is actually pretty cool. And then 1 Absolute Dragon. Basically, this card can be special summoned if you control a rocket monster. And also, if this card were to be sent to the graveyard, you can target one rocket monster in your deck and then add it to your hand, which is pretty cool. Then I'm running 3 Magna Rockets. So basically, what this card can do is that if a Link monster were to activate its effect, you can destroy this card, and then basically you can destroy that monster itself, which is pretty cool. Then you got 3 Auto Rockets, kind of the same thing with Magna Rocket. Instead of destroying a monster, you get to destroy a Spell and Trap card, which is really cool for any Spell and Trap removals. And then you got one Metal Rocket, which is the same as the other two, except when this card is destroyed, the card that's actually in the same column as this card is destroyed as well. And then you got two Rocket Synchrons. Basically, this card can actually special summon another rocket from the graveyard. Or actually, a level when this card is normal summoned, you can target a level 5 or higher dark monster. And the thing is, you cannot special summon any monsters except for dark monster, which it doesn't really matter because pretty much your entire deck are dark monsters. And then you got one Defrag Dragon, which is an easy special summon. You can just send one card from the graveyard to the graveyard and then special summon it, which is easy. And this is actually something that Rockets would actually want to do. And then for onto the spells, you got three Rapid Triggers. Obviously, this is actually for your Fusion Monster, Borlo Furious Dragon, and is also your win condition. Three Squib Draws. Basically, you just get to destroy a rocket and then draw two cards, which is actually pretty good. Three Quick Launch. Pretty much a special summon for your rockets. I don't know what else to say about it. Three Dragon Shines. This is actually another way to send your rockets to the graveyard since they're actually dragon types. Then I'm running two Boral Regenerators, and then I'm running one of Boot Sector Launch, again for more support for the rockets. And then I got three Twin Twisters, basically another spell card I meant, that's actually a spell and trap removal, which is pretty cool. And then the traps, I'm only running three traps, which are the same types. Three Red Reboot. I think you pretty much already have enough when it comes to the spell and trap removals, but Red Reboot is a really great trap removal, or I wouldn't say removal, but it prevents your opponent's trap from activating, which is something that's really cool to run. And then onto the extra deck, which there isn't really much in this in the extra deck considering on how many extra deck monsters that we got. So first we got three Borload Furious Dragons, your new Borload Fusion Monster, and of course this is your win condition. And it's also easy to go into this card because it only requires two Dark Dragon Monsters, which this is pretty much what Rockets are. They're Dark Dragon Monsters, so yeah, it's actually really easy to go to. Then I'm running three Quad Boral Dragons. Really good card. This is something you actually want to run, especially for like more Link Summons. And then three Booster Dragons. Again, same thing. A really great card. This is something you actually want to play more of for your more Link Summons. And then I'm running two Borload Dragons. Personally, I would actually just run one Borload because you're only going to be relating one Borload. But if you actually feel like you need to run two, which I have right now, then you can run two. But I wouldn't really need three Borlows. But anyways, Borload, I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys know what Borload does, so I don't really need to explain. And then I'm running one Triple Burst Dragon, which, again, I think a lot of you guys are familiar what Triple Burst Dragon does, and you don't really need to run more than one copies of Triple Burst, so yeah. And then last but not least, I'm running one Topologic Zero Borrow Dragon. Not Dragon. Zero Topologic Zero Borrow. So basically, that is it for my $30 deck profile. I really hope that you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.